it just doesn't seem like something Senator Sanders would say to a friend.
Right.
And if I had to go with who's lying and who's not, Elizabeth Warren has been caught lying just about her background and her past.
Elizabeth Warren, it's now her word against Senator Bernie Sanders, because Bernie Sanders has said, look, I don't know who's saying what, but they weren't in this meeting, and I would never say a woman couldn't win for president. Elizabeth was telling me she was going to run. Why would I say that?
Now, four sources tell CNN that Bernie Sanders responded to Elizabeth Warren by saying he does not believe that a woman can win. Now, we are also told that Sanders expressed some frustration about the role of identity politics for Democrats, and also that Elizabeth Warren disagreed with Sanders' assessment that a woman could not win. Now,
joining me now is Cathy Areu. She is the publisher of Catalina Magazine, and you may recognize her from Tucker Carlson Tonight. She has her own segment, and she's called the Liberal Sherpa. Great to have you here with us. So, Cathy, there's been a little bit of bad blood between some of the Democratic presidential candidates. I'm specifically talking about Senator Elizabeth Warren versus Senator Bernie Sanders. Now, it's kind of interesting, this back and forth that's happening right now, because they are friends. And what I'm specifically talking about is the fact that Elizabeth Warren is saying that Senator Bernie Sanders in a private meeting told her that he didn't think that a woman candidate could win, the presidency.
Right. Well, unfortunately, historically, he's right, because a female candidate has not won the presidency of the United States. So he's right. We haven't won yet. So historically, that's correct. I don't know if he said it or not. I don't think a guy who's been protesting since the 70s, pro-women, climate change, civil rights, would say such a thing. Maybe it was taken out of context. Kind of weird that Warren's campaign would come out with that. But then again, this is someone who had a wine vault and threw stones at a wine cave at Mayor Pete. So she's a contradiction. She's an enigma. You know, what she says is not what she means half the time.
So you're thinking, so somebody's lying here, right? So either Senator Bernie Sanders is lying, or Senator Elizabeth Warren is lying. And so she, you know, she's doubled down. She says she confirmed it in multiple reports that that's what he told her. And for some reason, I actually believe Sanders. I don't think he said this to her. And he pointed this out, and you know, he's standing firm on this. He says, I didn't say that. Why would I say that? After all, Hillary Clinton beat Donald Trump by 3 million votes in 2016. So it just doesn't seem like something Senator Sanders would say to a friend.
Right.
And if I had to go with who's lying and who's not, Elizabeth Warren has been caught lying just about her background and her past. I mean, she got caught red-handed about where she sent her kids to school. She said she sent them to public school when she was asked by somebody who was asking about schools and choice when it came to schools. She says, oh, well, I send my kids to public school. But it's not true. They actually went to private school. So why would she lie about that? She had to apologize for pretending that she had Native American background, and that was turns out false. And then what else did she make up? She made up the story about how she was either fired or not rehired at her job because she was visibly pregnant. But then the principal of that school said that that didn't happen. So yeah. And that they actually did offer her a job. So she seems to have a problem with honesty when it comes to just basic things in her life.
It's so sad, because the talk that she talks is great. I love it. But then when I'm asked to go on Fox News and can I defend her when she says that women should be paid equally as men? Absolutely. And then they find out that her staff, her females, are paid less than the males in her own staff.
Yeah, what's up with that? What a scam.
It's like, I can't defend it. So I've rationalized to myself, in order to be able to love her at the end of the day, is that the talk is beautiful. The talk is beautiful. The walk is not. So she talks beautifully, but when she walks the walk, she doesn't practice what she preaches. So that's the problem. If she could only practice what she preached, I'm 1,000,000% for what she says. But yeah, we've caught her too many times. I've written two op-eds for Fox News, and I'm the liberal on Fox News. But I have said, Mayor Pete, you know, he had those wine parties that we all didn't know about, and she just made so much fun of him about getting these $200 bottles of wine at these wine parties to get money to be on the stage as a candidate. And then she had wine vault parties, and she made people pay $3,000, $4,000 for bottles of wine that are $90 a bottle.
Yeah, it's extremely hypocritical. And, you know, I don't care if people are doing fundraisers with wine and the wine caves. That right. does not bother me. What bothers yeah. me is when people pretend they're like working class and poor, and then, you know, they're accepting money from everywhere when they say that they're not. And you're right, Elizabeth Warren was such a hypocrite in this instance because she was fact-checked on this. People yeah. looked into it and they're like, well, you just had one of those fundraisers in 2018. So why would you go out of your way to criticize Buttigieg over something that you just recently did? It's very dishonest. So I have to ask you, so did you support Senator Sanders back the last election? Were you a supporter at all? Did you vote for him?
Or no.
Hillary Clinton? Are you a fan of his? Do you like his platform? It seems very you.
I do. I actually love his platform. But for me, it's like, who can win? You know, and at the end of the day, I think that for Democrats right now with Trump, who can win? So at the end of the day, when you see like Bernie Sanders next to Trump, can Bernie win? You know, you see Warren next to Trump, can Warren win? So I just kind of like, for us, it's just basically who's going to win at the end of the day. So I don't know if Bernie, he seems so Larry David, you know, it's like perfect enthusiasm. Every time I see him, it's like, I just feel like he's going to go into one of his, you know, like skits or monologues. I don't know if he could beat the Donald. I don't know. You know, I feel like Bloomberg versus Trump, I think Bloomberg has a chance. I worked for the Bush administration during his last year, and it was a campaign year, and not for him, though, for McCain. And it was at the end of the day, it was all about who can win. And the messaging is so important. And I think a Bloomberg at the end of the day could win again. You know, I don't think a Sanders, a Bernie can win. I don't think so. Even though everything what he says, you know, a lot of people feel the burn. We all feel the burn. But wow. Can he win? Can he win?
I want to circle back to the Elizabeth Warren issue and tiff with Bernie Sanders. Do you think this was is this good strategy for her campaign to trash Senator Sanders, who's a friend? I thought they kind of had like a pact that they weren't going to go after each other. And although I did see something interesting, too, which I don't know if this is true or not, but according to Politico, Sanders volunteers were told to tell voters, that Elizabeth Warren was Senator Sanders' second choice, but Sanders had other reasons why you should support him. So but we'll get to that in a second. Back to Warren. Do you think this is a good strategy to attack Senator Sanders? Because you would think that she kind of has similar fan base. The people who support Sanders probably supports Warren, because I would argue that she stole Senator Sanders' platform. Like, that was his platform. And then she just took it over.
Exactly. And the people love her messaging. I mean, her messaging is right on point. When I talk to all my sources, they think her messaging is so strong. But now it's all about differentiating each other. So if everyone on stage is for climate change, is for education, federal education for all, is everything anti-Trump, everyone has to set themselves apart.
Yeah.
So Warren is setting herself apart by
playing victim,
a front runner, right? Which isn't Biden anymore. Biden's making his own mistakes. So now she's going after Sanders, who seems to be quite powerful. It shows you she's threatened by him. So she's beating up on him now, not Mayor Pete, because she already got rid of him with his wine case. So now she's going to go after the woman comment. So the strategy actually, I think, is more fun for the Republicans watching, because I know a lot of my Fox viewers, they love watching the debates more than the Democrats. The Democrats aren't even watching. They just read the New York Times the next day and just, you know, glimpse. I think it's like a show for the Trump supporters, the MAGA, you know, hat wearers. I think it's fun to watch these people attack each other when they're all on the same page.
But when you see this, are you like, oh no, why are they attacking each other? This isn't going to help us. Or do you think that that's going to help Senator Elizabeth Warren's campaign?
No, it never helps. So, I mean, when you saw the Republicans attacking each other, it didn't help anybody. And at the end of the day, like Barack Obama and Hillary, you know, they attack each other like crazy. And at the end of the day, she's Secretary of State. Yeah. And they're sitting by each other and they love each other. And we're like, but you made us, I thought you guys hated each other. So we're hating them, and at the end of the day, they're working together. So
okay, I guess it's just politics. I guess you can't take it too personal, but I don't think Senator Sanders is just going to sit around and take this. I think he's going to step it up.
Well, he's an angry man. I think it all.
Angry man.
He seems so angry. He seems so angry to me every time I watch those debates, and everyone seems so chill. And then you get the little. I'm so mean, but it's the Larry David. He's so.
Wait, what do you have against Larry David? That's a great show, Curb Your Enthusiasm. I've seen it a few times. But Larry David's not a Trump fan. I know that, but I still watch his show.
SNL. He played him on SNL, and it was beautiful. Like Tina Fey with Sarah Palin. I mean, they nail it because he seems so angry. And I was like, I don't want angry grandpa in the White House. But if he has, you know, free university, free healthcare, all that stuff, I feel the burn.
Well, we can worry about who's going to pay for that later, right?
Like the wall.
Uh-huh. Well, quick question. So we know that Senator Cory Booker dropped out of the race, and a lot of people are upset about it. They're saying, oh, well, now the once historic field is a lot less diverse. So with all of the minorities and women kind of dropping out of the race here, does this suggest that Democrat primary voters are racist and anti-woman?
Well, we still have two women. So we have two women tonight.
Yeah, we'll see how long they last. I don't know. The Democrats, that's what they would say about Republicans. It's like, if you don't support a person of color, you're racist, inherently racist. So explain to me what's going on with our Democratic primary voters.
Well, it's the same argument, right? I mean, right now you just have Trump. No one's going against Trump. He's a white guy. He's an older white guy. So is every Republican.
Yeah, it's just so typical. Like, that's the argument that they throw at us all the time. But, like, let's flip it around and talk about it in the Democratic sense. You think that they would be, you know, they're the party of diversity, yet the stage is very less diverse, coming up.
Well, going back to Warren, it's really funny because when they asked Warren, there early on during the day, if Warren, it was true between Bernie and Warren, the people who came out for Warren were white men, saying that women can't be president. You know, that they were blaming Bernie Sanders, but then the women, the people defending her, were white men. So it's like, oh my God, you can't even defend yourself using females on your staff. So it's like,
so is that something that you thought of? As we're like getting into this now, we're 2020 and so many people are dropping out of the race, dropping like flies.
Yep.
Is this what you have? What do you make of it?
It's so depressing because we've had countries that are super conservative. They're very religious, and there's South America, Central America, Ireland have had women as presidents. We've had female presidents, and all these countries that we're saying are so backwards. And we're the most advanced industrial nation in the world. And we can't have a woman, for goodness sake. And it's just really depressing. I wish the guys would just step aside and just give us a break this year and let a woman lead. You know, like, come on. Stephanie would be great. Like, if you could just talk to Trump and say, you know, can you just give 2020 a break? And let me, you know, I'd vote for you, Stephanie. I would.
Would you really? You'd vote for a Republican?
Not Sarah Palin, but I'd vote for you. Yeah.
Thank you. I appreciate that. And we kind of had this conversation out of all the Democratic candidates. You're keeping a close eye, obviously. Is there anyone that you see that's running right now that could beat Trump?
What I said, yeah, I feel when you put them side by side, my sources they like Bloomberg, you know, Wall Street. I have a lot of people on Wall Street connections.
But I thought Democrats hate rich people. So it's like they hate billionaires.
They do not.
Senator Sanders' platform, you know, he's always railing against the rich and the millionaires and billionaires. Yet he is a millionaire and he has like three mansions. He flies private.
Right. But he has to go against. How do you disqualify two people running against you? Billionaire. Out. You know, so that
I don't have anything against billionaires, by the way. I just want to make that clear.
No, I'd like to be a billionaire. There's a popular song by Bruno Mars. You know,
I remember it. It's a good one.
I'd love to be a millionaire, a billionaire, and do so many things. But I spoke with Tom Steyer this week. I interviewed him for my podcast that you're going to be on, Liberal Sherpa Podcast. But I interviewed Tom Steyer, and he was so passionate. And I really tried to drill into him. And he just... he seemed like a really chill dude, and I liked what he said. And, sometimes a billionaire is like Bloomberg. He's not bought and paid for. No one likes a bought and paid for politician. So if we like the American dream, and these are self-made people in the United States who follow the American dream, and they end up in the White House, and then they help us reach our American dream, I love my billionaires.
Yeah, well, that's what President Trump did now.
No, he inherited about $400 million from his daddy.
Well, he's still pretty well off. And I guess my last question is, not that you have a crystal ball or anything, but if you had to guess the top three candidates that are going to survive the Democratic primary, who do you think are going to be the top three?
Bloomberg. He can't run out of money. Money is oxygen in a political campaign, and he's got the oxygen. The tanks, Kamala Harris, ran out of oxygen. You know, they're all just running. Kerry Booker ran out of oxygen, didn't have money. So the ones with the money, unfortunately, money talks right now. So the three with the money, the top money. And if Warren keeps criticizing the fundraisers and begging for $2 donations, she's out. So we're going to have three white guys. We're going to have three white guys. We're going to have Bloomberg. We're going to have Tom Steyer. And we're going to have Larry David. I mean, Bernie Sanders.
Well, thank you so much for your insight, Cathy. I really appreciate it.
Thank you so much.